In this video, I'm gonna show how to work with the Baked Lighting Environment filter from Substance Painter. This filter bakes color information from an HDRI to our base color, useful to work on situations where we have to save resources and we can work only with a base color map, without relying on other texture maps from PBR rendering like metallic or roughness. Or maybe work on models for mobile phone games or modding projects for old games, where you cannot afford complex lighting. So this option could be very useful to add more detail and realism to your props. This filter is similar to the Baked Lighting Stylized filter or even the Light Mask Generator, but those are material for a different video. Now, to start, this filter is added to a paint layer, instead of a mask or a fill layer like other filters. Right now, our material is looking completely white. That's because down the properties section of the filter, I have only applied the ambient occlusion input. Now I have to add the HDRI map, for example Tomoko Studio. With the HDRI added to the filter, the next step is change the blending mode, so the filter doesn't completely cover our texturing. For me, the best option is overlay, but it's up to you to experiment on this regard. Before we continue working with the filter, I recommend to change the visualization from material to base color, because right now, the lightning from the scene is having effect on the model, so it's a bit difficult to distinguish between the scene lightning and the base color change from the filter. Now it's easier to see what we are doing, and change to our liking the different properties for the filter, like horizontal and vertical rotation of the HDRI map we are using, and different settings like exposure or ambient occlusion intensity. Right now, I'm gonna be showing two different images, and without explaining what's happening on them, it's difficult to know what effect they are using. The left one shows a common render without the baking environment filter, and the right one is the Substance Painter viewport while showing only base color information using the baking environment filter, without any rendering. The result is so convincing that sometimes I even forgot what visualization mode I was using while working. Before finishing, this filter has a little problem. By default, it doesn't take into account the normal or ambient occlusion details added while texturing. For example, if I add some normal stamp to the texture, I can observe the effect on the material mode, but going back to the base color visualization, it's impossible to distinguish. The filter is not taking those details into account. This happens because, by default, it's using the normal and ambient occlusion baked mesh maps, so that information is not there. To fix this, there are two options. The first one being export the normal map or occlusion with the new added details, and reimport them as mesh maps, but this is very slow and destructive to be a viable solution. The best option for this problem are anchor points. If you don't know how to use them, in a future I want to do a tutorial about them. But as a quick summary for this video, what I will do after adding all the normal details I want on different layers to try and make this example closer to a real texturing project, I'll add a blank paint layer in top of the other layers, except the layer with the baked environment filter, and add an anchor point to this layer. On the normal channel, I'll change the blending mode for this layer to pass through, so it will show the information from the previous layers. Then, below all the layers used, I'll add a fill layer with the normal baked mesh map used on this project. If we have the normal mixing method on combine on the texture set settings, the baked normal details will show more intense, so it's best to use replace as our mix method. After this setup, I'll come back to the baked environment filter and change the normal map input from the previous mesh map to the anchor point I just created, and select the references channel to normal map. Now, the normal details are adding information to the baked lighting environment filter, and this method would also work if we want to add new ambient occlusion information. And that was all I wanted to talk about this filter. It's not a very used tool on modern games or films, as today we have very powerful real-time render engines, but for mobile phone or older games, it's very interesting to know how it works.